Hill House, not sane, stood by itself against its hills, holding darkness within.
8:35, take four.
Our show is about a mom and dad and five kids, and a brief summer in Hill House. More important than the horror for me was always the human drama. If we loved these characters, and if we truly could empathize with them on a personal level, we wouldn't be able to stop ourselves from being afraid for them. Olivia and Hugh were kind of model parents.
She's an architect and married a contractor.
I designed them and
Daddy built them.
The Crane family finds this house in rural Massachusetts, and of course it all goes horribly wrong.
We catch up with this family 25 years later, but all of them were traumatized by a night that became famous worldwide.
I can't imagine what it was like living at the most famous haunted house in America.
It wasn't famous when we moved in.
The oldest kid is Steven.
Throughout the story, he sees ghosts, but he doesn't realize they're ghosts.
Steven decided to write a book about his childhood, basically about everything that you experienced.
Dad said it was haunted.
When he said those things, he believed them. You never did.
Shirley is the second child. She is the one who is reliable and responsible. She's grown up to become a funeral director.
She wants to take care of her siblings, but they have their own sets of issues.
She can be really tough because she wants to protect her family, and you feel the tension building.
I said you could live here. I wasn't expecting the pussy parade. You're worse than a guy. You're like a frat guy.
The next sibling is Theo. In the brief time that she spent in Hill House, something changed in her.
She sees lots of scary things sometimes.
Your grandmother was like that, too. She was sensitive.
Her two older siblings don't believe in ghosts, whereas the twins below her definitely believe in ghosts.
You're scared. I can tell. How? Because I'm scared.
Luke and Nell have the most intense supernatural experiences in the house out of anyone.
There's something down here.
They're the only ones that really, like, see and believe each other.
They're told that they're imagining.
They never believe me.
And so that carries out into their adult life in quite a serious way.
The ghosts of our story not only exist on the screen to scare us, but also exist in the souls and in the minds of our characters, because every single person on screen is haunted by something.